Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. There will be plenty of pressure on a pair of safeties who will be counted on to make some big plays. It's Thomas's Seahawks going up against McCourty's Patriots. On the call here tonight, let's send it out to our guys in the booth. That's Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Larry, we are about an hour's drive southwest of downtown Boston in the area known as Patriot Place, Gillette Stadium here in Foxborough. Coming up is a rematch of that memorable Super Bowl 49 between the Seattle Seahawks and the New England Patriots. And a welcome in, everybody, with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden, and Charles, so much gets made about offensive comparisons. Here's a matchup where the defenses may just take center stage.
Yeah, we're usually talking about guys scoring touchdowns. How about the guys who prevent them and change the momentum of the game when they take the ball away? I love those ball hawks in the secondary. People after my own heart.
Their meeting in Super Bowl 49 was thrilling. What's in store here? The Pats and Seahawks are underway. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And last year, that would have been a net gain of 5 on the return. This year, he stopped where he would have been if he had taken a knee. And that's at the 25. So out come the Seahawks now for their first possession. They'll be led out by a man who's been a Pro Bowler in 3 of his first 4 NFL seasons. From Wisconsin, it's Russell Wilson.
Coming out of college, he graded out A-plus in every category you want in a quarterback, except height. And that's what moved him to a third-round pick. And we all found out later that was a mistake. He should have been a first-round guy. Now, in 2015, he showed his ability to actually lead a team to victories by being able to throw the football, not just rely on the running game.
They'll throw on first down with Wilson. And the grab made by Doug Baldwin. They give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
I don't care how many times you tell the story, it never loses its luster for me. Doug Baldwin, undrafted out of Stanford, and plays like a number one receiver should in the NFL. I don't care how you cover him. I don't care that his size isn't great. He's the one that typically comes up with the football.
Absolutely. His roots go all the way back to Gulf Breeze, Florida, where he's from, right on the water near Pensacola, and then, of course, to Stanford, and boy, he's been good. Now the fourth-year man from Texas A&M, Christian Michael. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
2nd down following the run. On 2nd down, here's Wilson. Baldwin with it over the middle. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues. And he's already got 2 catches on the opening drive. They know he's going to be a handful.
And sometimes you game plan for that offensively. You want to make sure that guy touches the ball. And sometimes it just happens naturally. And then you change your game plan. When he has the hot hand, you keep going back to him because he's running routes with confidence as the game goes on.
On 1st and 10, it's Wilson. It's caught on the left side by Kurz. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42.
I really don't know where to go with this one. He caught the pass, but in the opposite direction towards his own end zone. That's not one you get every game.
On 2nd down, Wilson, and that is incomplete. Jimmy Graham, the intended receiver. 3rd down here. And this offense often hinges on one of the best tight ends in the league, and that's Jimmy Graham.
I think he made up for lost time when he got to the NFL because in college, he was mainly a basketball player, a defender who couldn't score. Now he's flipped it around in the NFL. Every time he touches the ball, he's a threat to score.
And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Third and long, it's Wilson. He hits Baldwin right side. And a nifty little Deke Juke spin move. Not a great deal there on the back end, but a nice gain still.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
So on fourth down, here's the Canadian-born punter, John Ryan, to kick it away for Seattle. Back deep, Danny Amendola for New England. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. Here come the New England Patriots, and setting into your view on your set, Tom Brady. He has thrown 12 touchdowns, no interceptions since returning this year, and white hot is New England, 7-1.
And when you think about Brady and what he's done this season, I come up with one term for him: locked in. I mean, right now he is in sync with his receivers, his offensive line is protecting him, and he is as good as he has been as a player since he entered the league.
Now on first down, and his first pass here is going to fall incomplete. Julian Edelman, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down. Let's discuss this offense now, and Julian Edelman, very good player.
Has really developed into a terrific slot receiver, and a lot of times he would be the primary receiver. Still mad coming out of college that he's not a quarterback in the NFL. He takes it out on the opposing defenses.
Looking back to the air on second down, it's Brady. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. And a look at Seattle's defense.
When Bobby Wagner's career is said and done, people are going to look back and say he was an absolute steal in the NFL draft. A Pro Bowl player for any team.
Ten yards to go on third. Throwing is Brady on third down. Surveying the field. And now a fumble. Brady loses the football. And they bring this one back. It's a fumble recovery and a Seattle touchdown. Huge, huge play by the defense, not only to force the fumble, obviously, but to return it for a touchdown.
And I know it's no fun for anyone who plays offense, but isn't it fun to see how a defense rallies when there's a fumble return and everyone tries to find someone to block and bring it all the way home?
I always like their celebrations because they don't get there that often.
No, they're not choreographed very well usually.
Steven Hauschka for the point after. And this will give the Seahawks a 7-0 lead. So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. And the Patriots gearing up to go now. Just shy of the 30. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. They'll run again with Blunt. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football. In that situation, that's almost a tendency breaker.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. Now to Blunt, and he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now 2nd down.
But when it comes to the running game, the New England Patriots, they're one of the few teams in the NFL that I don't think care much about balancing things out.
Last year, to your point, 5th in passing yardage, number 30 in the run game.
What they want to do each and every week is make a game plan based on their opponent, not so much their own personnel, and they try to attack that way.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be taken down here as it will take us to the end of the first quarter. So 1 quarter in the books. It's a rematch of Super Bowl 49. 7-0 is our score, and we'll return to Foxborough after this.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Patriots in possession to begin quarter number 2. They're looking at a 3rd and 6 here to start things out. They slot Gronkowski outright. From the gun on 3rd down, Brady, and he'll have his man, that's Edelman. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. The former 7th-round pick, Julian Edelman, just continues to have such a productive career.
And has made himself into a receiver. Remember, he was a college quarterback, and not just a productive one, a very good one.
At Kent State, right?
Yes, a great leader, a guy who could make plays with his feet and his arm. Got to the NFL and had to convert into being a receiver and was drafted that way. And that conversion, oh boy, it's been good.
Now a carry for Blunt. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the 1st down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
They fake the handoff. Now Brady finding time. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Unable to get it to Gronkowski that time. And it's 3rd and 4.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups, and they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
Check. Here's the seventh play of this drive. This is third and four. Gronkowski, slot left. They go play action for White. Now it's Brady. And he dropped it. Now it was tipped. Altered the ball a little bit, but he dropped it. And now fourth down.
But, partner, anytime someone tells me that fundamentals are leaving the game, I'm going to show them this play because they couldn't get to the passer. So what do you have to do? Get your hands up in the passing lane, and they batted it away on a third down attempt.
And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. And the Seahawks get ready to trot out on the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
And not great starting field position here for the offense. On the ground, it's Michael. And he'll get this up past the 5 to the 7-yard line.
Holding offense.
So there you go, holding by the offense, and that'll push him back.
Changes everything now as you try and figure out what your playbook has for you. Longer yardage situations, tougher to execute and pick up first downs.
Now the free kick comes after the safety from the 20 as they bring the punter on to try and get some hang time here. This will be taken at the 10. He juked him. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. And last time out they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up, but you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over, right? You're giving your defense a chance because you're punting the ball away and they're set to go on the field as opposed to sudden change after a turnover and wow, now we've got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
On first down, Brady. Amendola catching it left side. Call it a gain of 3, and it'll make it a second down.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route, and what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works a defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing, and they got it done.
Here we go, a second and 7. To throw on second down. And his throw is going to be incomplete. The wideout Chris Hogan, the intended receiver. And that'll make it third down. So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. To throw is Brady. This is White on the screen. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensing the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense It worked very well there for a first down.
Blunt, the lone running back. Now they'll run it on the toss. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
As I watch that play unfold, stereotypes were being broken left and right. As a corner, you're often back there guarding against the pass. But how about that diagnosis and read and getting into the backfield and making a nice play and a tackle?
Right. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. Back to Foxborough after this. Back now, as I search for my cue card here, there we go. Coming up at halftime, Larry Ridley will join us from Orlando. He'll have highlights and analysis from our first half of play.
Well read.
Yeah, thank you. It's a five receiver set, three to the left, two to the right. Now Brady throwing on second down to the right side, and he's got Edelman. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and that'll lead here to a third down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Play action. Now it's Brady. Over the middle. That's caught by Hogan. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive. They go play action here on first down. He's got time. Look at the time. And he's going to find Hogan here, complete. And he is down deep into Seattle territory. A big play there for the Patriots. 39 yards.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make it routine. How about that throw right there? Yeah. Another great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Wow, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
Think he gunned down a few guys?
Gunned down a few guys trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch.
Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. Into the red zone, it's Brady. This is caught, Gronkowski. And he's going to get into the end zone. So cue up the Gronk spike, gets a Patriot touchdown. Rob Gronkowski, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And once again, the Patriots are back out in front.
And while that touchdown does not give them an insurmountable lead, it's still a lead, and that always feels good to a team.
They'd love to take that into the lockers, but a little time left on that clock, so some work to do.
I like that. I like how you're guarding against a letdown there.
Marty looking forward.
Coaching them up from right up here in the booth.
Gronkowski now, after the touchdown, he'll send this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting.
And he goes down. It's a Patriots sack. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. Second down, here's Wilson. It's caught on the left side by Baldwin. And he's brought down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And welcome back, the offensive unit. They took the timeout. And now they get set to line up as we resume action. Fresh set of downs here.
Hey, pick your game up.
Throwing now, Wilson on first down. And this is caught. It's Jimmy Graham. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And they're going to speed things up here. Now a play fake here on first down. He's got time in the pocket. He's going to go for a big play downfield. The intended target, Doug Baldwin. And it's second down.
The best receivers we know always tease their quarterbacks to, hey, no matter what you do, you cannot overthrow me. Well, guess what? That's exactly what happened on that play. Normally, they time it up pretty well, but on that one, he just overshot him.
Graham slotted out to the left. Second and 10 now, Wilson. And he comes back with one complete. And he's brought down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So the offensive unit called the TO. And now we are ready to resume play. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. From the left hash, this will be a 52-yard attempt. And Hauschka's kick is good. And with that, they'll take a one-point lead here in the second. So they kick it through to take the lead. There is a little bit of time left, though, here in the second quarter.
And while they're concerned about not giving up a big return or giving up points themselves going into the half, how good do they feel, though, putting points on the board themselves right near the end of the first half?
Now after the made field goal, Hauschka back out onto the field to kick it away. Danny Amendola on the return. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And with time running short here, they'll simply take a knee, and that should do it for half number one. So we've come upon halftime with the visiting Seahawks. They're out in front as we send you down to Orlando, where we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Larry.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Patriots right now have a time of possession advantage, but it has not led them to taking control of this game. The Seahawks look like they'll be in this game for four quarters. So let's take a look at the highlights from the first half. Patriots line up at the 13. Gronkowski is able to get open here, and it ends up working for a touchdown. They would go ahead by two. Seahawks with the ball late in the half. Graham has the catch coming across the middle, and he'll eventually be brought down, but not before getting to the 47-yard line. They go on to kick a field goal to end the drive. We're set up for a great second half, so let's get you out to it. Here's Brandon Godden.
All right, thank you, Larry. Plenty of intrigue to come. A one-point game as we get set for half two. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This is taken at the three. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. And time now for the Seahawk defense to take their spots again on the field. They look good in the first half. They'll be looking to carry that momentum over into half number two.
Finish a game the way you started it. That's typically the message at halftime when things are going well. You've done everything you're expected to do. How about a little bit more of that in the second half? But be aware, they may throw something different at you to begin things.
Yeah, 50% of the equation still left to go. Brady now on first down. To the left side and complete for Julian Edelman. And he's going to be out of bounds up around the 45-yard line. A good pick up there of 20 yards. And finding Edelman underneath, that's a recipe for success.
Typical route for a good slot receiver, and Edelman's one of the best in the game. Knows how to go inside what one of my college coaches used to call the Briar Patch. Got to go in there where it's tough and make those tough catches. And not only can he do it, he can often run away from people after the catch.
So here we go, first and 10 now. On first and 10, here's Brady. Quickly to Gronkowski, that's caught. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. They'll give him 8 on the play, and that'll bring up second down.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
They'll run it here with Blunt. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
All right, Brandon, you know me as well as anyone. You know I don't usually advocate abandoning things during a game, but here we are in the second half. I think it's time to change things up. Let the running game go a little bit. Let's get to the passing game, and if you still want to get in the hands of the runner, maybe you swing it to him, throw it to him a little bit. Try it that way.
An extra defensive back in the game now here for third and four. Working from the gun, it's Brady. And he will find his man. That's Hogan complete. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. pretty good location there on that throw.
It really was, wasn't it? That was likely one where the receiver was either going to catch it or no one. Really good decision. And boy, what a catch and move right there.
In a tough spot to get it over the middle. On first down, Brady. And he'll find his favorite receiver. That's Edelman. And he's brought down. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Get him down right about the 20. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Now Brady throwing on 2nd down. Looking for someone to throw to. And he's gonna go down. He's sacked back in the 24. They get to him for a loss of 4. And it brings up 3rd down on the sack. Well, this has been a pretty sizable drive. They've had some success. Finally, the defensive coordinator found some success of his own.
I think he just simply said enough of that. Okay, they've moved the ball well. We need to force the issue from our end. And that's exactly what he did.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on 3rd down. They go play action for White. Now it's Brady surveying the field. All kinds of time. Under pressure, and they got to him again. Cliff Averill in there to drop him, and back-to-back sacks now bring up 4th and long. Well, they went with a nickel. They throw in an extra defensive back. Coverage was very good.
Yeah, it was exactly as you would expect. A passing down, you bring in the nickel package. Just as you described, the coverage was excellent and allowed one of their linemen to end up getting to the quarterback.
Gostkowski now for the Pats field goal try. They'll put it down right at the 40, so call this a 50-yard attempt. And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost, and they take the lead here by 2, 12-10. A little bit of a lower trajectory there on the deep kick, and it worked.
Had to do it because he had to drive it out low because of the length of the kick. Able to do that, got it above the defense and over the post.
Gostkowski now converted for 3. Now he'll kick this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. A chance for us to get a glance at this Patriots defense. And even though that last drive yielded points, it was a long field goal, so they probably weren't too upset about it. Although here, obviously, they'd like to give up 0.
Of course, that's the goal each and every time out. But when they make that type of a field goal that long, you almost give them a little nod of respect to the kicker, like, congratulations. But you do feel pretty good about not giving up anything big.
Yeah, and we'll see if they can not give up anything big on this drive. This is Michael, and he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up 2nd down. And yet again, this run game just continues to be completely shut off.
Completely stymied. Hey, they're trying to get some consistency, trying to find places to roam. They just haven't been there throughout this game.
We have played three quarters. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Foxborough. It's been a good one so far. Just a two-point game here as we get set for quarter number four. And they're behind the sticks here a bit now, dealing with a second and 12. Graham slotted out to the left. Now Wilson on second down. It's caught on the left side by Baldwin. And he goes out of bounds across the 40-yard line.
And another thing that makes a comeback route really effective is that oftentimes after you've made the initial move, receivers breaking away from the defensive back, and that makes it a really tough play to defend. A nice chunk of yardage picked up there.
On first down, Wilson. And Graham's got it over the middle. And he's brought down. Give him 11 on the gain there. And that'll be good for a Seattle first down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give him a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. It's the replacement for Chandler Jones, Chris Long, in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. In a play like that, with how far he had to go to make that sack, shows how athletic defensive ends have become in the NFL.
And not just athletic. This is coached in a big way. Run to the football at all times. How about him never giving up on it and pursuing all the way across the field?
On second down, here's Wilson finding time. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete.
An extra corner on the field for New England here on third down.
Yeah, another DB. Here's Wilson. He's got time. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down. Here's John Ryan now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. The kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds. We focus our attention on the Seahawks defense now. And a field goal surrendered the last time out. Just by and large, are field goals wins for the defensive side?
They certainly are in today's football because offenses are so tuned up and usually have the ability to strike almost at will that when you're only giving up 3, you feel like it's almost like basketball. You're trading, right? I give up 3 on my end. I'm counting my offense to get 6 on the other, and that is a win.
Yeah, it's a win for the kicker, too, I guess, if he makes the field goal, right?
No doubt about it. He feels good about things, but his team feels like they settled.
On first and 10, here's Brady. Wide open, Gronkowski. And he's brought down after a good game. A nice gain of 21 yards.
seeing Rob Gronkowski run that flag route brings back memories of high school for me, because I remember my coach being so detailed with the receivers about how to sell the inside part of the route, like you're going to the post, and then breaking it off for that flag towards that pylon. And how about Gronk? Once he does that, who's going to be able to go through that big body and stop it?
Not me. Well, the offense lining up first and 10. Throwing on first down is Brady. Over the middle, it's Amendola. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. It'll be a gain of 9, and it'll be second and about a yard.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
Now Blunt, and he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. Only 3 there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
Second and 1 is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
Getting late here in the fourth, and if this team has any chance to win this football game, their defense obviously needs a stop here. So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. So the offense has it first and 10. Again, here's Blum. And he is going to loop. Now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. All right, so the timeout over and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense. Still left looking at a 3rd and about 9 to go. And now the Seahawks are going to call another timeout. That'll be their 2nd, so 1 more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. And they'll need to get to the 35 if they want to keep this drive going on 3rd down. They'll run it here. This is James White. And he's going to be met at about the 43. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their 3rd and final stoppage here as we step aside. So a defensive timeout, chance to regather, regroup, and get set as we resume action. Here's Ryan Allen now, as he'll kick it away for the 2nd time. The Seahawks. And they'll be looking to avoid what happened last time, which is punting the football.
But when you look at how teams play the game, that complementary football comes into play. How do I take care of my defense? How do I take care of my offense? Well, the defense is taking care of them in a lot of ways. Now it's time for the offense to jump things up and help their defense out. Give them a little bit of rest.
Yeah, time for them to give them a rest. You took the words right out of my mouth. They'll look to throw. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. Back to throw. He's got time in the pocket. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Well, that plays a statistic that's going to go on the defensive team stat sheet. Won't necessarily reflect in ours, right, the overall game sheet. But you and I know that they keep count on pressures, hits on quarterbacks, all those things, hoping to increase that throughout the game. And here we are in the fourth quarter, and they got a big one.
Yeah, it's such a close game, a very big one. He'll look to throw. Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. And it'll be first and goal at the 7-yard line.
Well, that simply is a missed opportunity. They're in position. If they take the ball downfield and score, they've got a chance to win the game. Instead, they cough it up. I don't think next week at practice is going to be a whole lot of fun for him.
On the other side, no bigger time to force a turnover when you've got that small lead.
Yeah, and when you look at it from the offense's perspective, taking care of the ball, so important. I know they're going to have all kind of ball security drills in practice all next week.
Brady gonna throw here. And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown. But what a quick turnaround there. They get the football. Next play, boom, touchdown.
I've been in a situation before where a turnover occurs. If you're over on the bench with your defensive mate and you talk about what to do on your next series, and all of a sudden you hear sudden change, you got to get out on the field and defend right away. Not everyone is mentally prepared to go.
Is that what is yelled on the sidelines a lot of times?
That, among other things.
Maybe some words we can't share here.
Yeah, we'll just keep this one PG.
FCC violation.
No doubt.
Gostkowski for the point after. And that makes it a 9-point game. Gostkowski now after the touchdown. He'll send this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Seahawks offense now, they get set to go back to work. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, two-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again. But they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly. Then they'll take it from there.
Throwing now is Wilson. Surveying the field. Fighting his safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. It's a gain of 7, and that'll make it a second down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Here's Wilson. And the catch is made here by Tyler Lockett. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains. And Charles, in this situation, this is where the word miracle comes into play.
Have to score real fast, maybe throw a jump ball in the end zone and hope for the best.
Wilson to throw. Complete outright to Kurz. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And now they're in the hurry up. Still needing 10 yards. Second down. Now Wilson. Over the middle here to Wilson. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup, and they're going to face a third down. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Wilson, and he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
And that catch there by Luke Wilson goes for a first down, and he's really developed and come on. Now, remember, Jimmy Graham, who was expected to be the key tight end for Russell Wilson, he was hurt most of 2015. Luke Wilson really jumped his game up.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. First and 10, it's Wilson. And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. Jabal Sheard in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. And quickly, they get to the line. One last shot for Wilson. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game. And Charles, you know what coaches always tell us. We want to win our home games. That much we know. We want to protect our home turf. They got that done in this one.
Exactly right. When you start a season, everyone's goal, win all of your home games, split your road games, and you're likely going to be in the playoffs. But when you win at home, boy, what a great feeling that is. You don't even mind if people are at your house when you get home after a win like that.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Patriots, winners here at home as we...